Hello everyone. In this unit on musical nationalism, this lesson introduces Peter Tchaikovsky. Peter Ilyich Tchaikovsky was a Russian composer who expertly balanced European musical traditions and Russian nationalist ideals in his work. Tchaikovsky was born and raised in a small town in Russia. He took piano lessons as a child, but he did not receive more formal musical instruction until the age of 20, when he took music classes at the Russian Musical Society. There, he met and formed lifelong relationships with a group of Russian nationalist composers known as the Mighty Five. The RMS encouraged local composers like Tchaikovsky to write music that used Russian folk songs and scales. When he was 22, Tchaikovsky enrolled at the new St. Petersburg Conservatory, where he studied traditional European harmony and counterpoint and was exposed to all kinds of non-Russian music. The Mighty Five did not approve of the teachings at this conservatory, but Tchaikovsky managed to keep a good relationship with them. He did not fully subscribe to the teachings of either school, and instead he worked to create a new style of music that combined the best of both European and Russian characteristics. After graduating, Tchaikovsky got a job at the Moscow Conservatory, where he composed and taught music theory. He also worked as a music critic, which gave him the opportunity to travel abroad and hear the works of non-Russian composers like Beethoven, Brahms, and Schumann. During his years at the Moscow Conservatory, Tchaikovsky wrote his first successful work, a concert overture called Romeo and Juliet. He also wrote his second and third symphonies, his first piano concerto, the ballet Swan Lake, and a Slavic concert overture called March Slav. In 1877, Tchaikovsky married a former student but left her after a disastrous 2.5 months. Tchaikovsky fell into a depression and spent the next 5 years traveling alone throughout Europe and Asia, avoiding social contact whenever possible. During this difficult time, Tchaikovsky finished his Serenade for Strings, a violin concerto, his Fourth Symphony, and 2 concert overtures, Capriccio Italien and his 1812 overture. Through his travels, Tchaikovsky became quite famous, and in 1884, the Russian Tsar awarded him with a title of nobility, which came with a lifetime annual salary. This very public show of approval helped the composer come out of his depression and re-enter public life. He finally settled back down in Russia, and in the last 9 years of his life, Tchaikovsky wrote his 2 ballets, Sleeping Beauty and Nutcracker, and his last 2 symphonies. Tchaikovsky conducted the premiere of this last work in St. Petersburg just 9 days before his death. Now read the lesson in your workbook and answer the questions in the study guide to review the unit. My name is Christopher Selby. Thank you for watching this tutorial on music theory for the successful string musician.